Hello friends, welcome to my channel Prostoha and to the last session of Pankim and Shula philosophy. So till now we have discussed how to restore the lower posterior teeth, and in this session we'll be discussing our final step, that is restoration of the upper posterior teeth using the functionally generated path technique. So the upper posterior teeth is our last segment that needs to be restored. So in our previous session, we have discussed how to restore the lower posterior teeth, how to place the buccal cusp, the lingual cusp, how to give the fossa contours and the fossa inclines and lateral ridges and grooves. So based on these lower posterior teeth and the pathways that the lower posterior teeth follow, we are going to set our upper posterior teeth. So this is done by the method that is functionally generated path technique. So as you can see here, this is the fossa contouring guide which help us to ensure that our fossa inclines are proper in the lower posterior teeth. To know more about this fossa contouring guide, you can watch my previous session of full mouth rehabilitation. The link is given in the description box below. So we usually prefer to tie this fossa contouring guide on our articulator, so it will enable us to check our fossa inclines after setting it. Now, in cases of immediate disclusion, we have to remember that there should not be any contact against any incline during excursive movement. That means as soon as the mandible moves from centric relation, it needs to be discluded. That is in cases of immediate disclusion. And this disclusion is easily accomplished if our lateral anterior guidance is steeper than our lower posterior inclines. This lateral anterior guidance we have discussed in our previous session. To know more detail about it, please do watch my previous session of full mouth rehabilitation. And the disclusion for easily accomplishment, our condylar path also needs to be healthy and sufficiently disclosive in their angulation. Now in cases of group function, we know that on the working side, all the posterior teeth has to contact in harmony with the anterior guidance in the front and the condyle in the back. But you can see that the length of the contact stroke is not uniform. In this picture, you can see as we move distally, the length of the contact stroke decreases. So the first teeth that needs to disengage is the most posterior molars. So the molar contact is maintained only for a fraction of the inclined surface, while the canine is having the contact all the way up to its incisal tip. So it is the canine which is having the longest contact stroke, and why we are giving this is based on factors of stress and geometry. So if we are providing the complete contact for the molar like that of the canine, what happens is that the protection from our anterior guidance will be lost and there may be too much stress on the outer incline of the molar. So to prevent this, we always give this progressive contact stroke. Next is the functionally generated path technique. So this is the method of rehabilitating the upper posterior teeth using the functionally generated path record based on the modification of principles which were advised by Mayer and Brenner in 1933. So we already discussed that our border pathways of the lower posterior teeth are usually dictated by two different determinants. One is the condylar guidance, other one is the anterior guidance. Now, Mayer has described this technique first for removal prosthetic procedures, and it was Dr. Arvind Mann who used this in our oral rehabilitation. And it was through a creation of a particular model that is called as the stone core or the functional core. So the summary of this FGP is that the prepared teeth are coated with a tacky wax, that is a functional wax that is soft enough to move when chewed against. And this prepared teeth, after coating with the tacky wax, we are recording directly all possible border pathways of our lower posterior teeth, as they are influenced by condylar guidance and anterior guidance. So these border pathways will be recorded in our functional wax, and this movement we are recording it in our stone core. So once we get our stone core, we wax up the upper posterior teeth according to this stone core. Let us see in detail about FGP. So before that, Dawson and Schillingberg et al. Noted following prerequisites for use of FGP. So first one is the presence of optimal occlusion. Second one, correct anterior guidance should be there. Third one, absence of posterior interferences. And the final requisite is that adequate opposing occlusal surfaces capable of generating a functional path. That means there should not be any rotation or carious lesion or deficient restoration. The opposing occlusal surface should be able to generate a functional path. So these were the requirements according to Dawson and Schillingberg. You can expect this as a Viva question. So let us begin with our FGP technique. So the final segment that needs to be restored is our upper posterior teeth. So we have done the tooth preparation on our upper posterior teeth, and then we are covering it this with hard or extra hard base plate wax, which act as a base for adapting our functional wax on it. So while adapting it, you have to be careful that it should cover all the prepared teeth and also an unprepared teeth in the front, the canine, which act as the key tooth. So it should be stable and there should not be any contact while closing it with the lower segment. Around 0.5 mm of space should be there between this base plate wax and the opposing teeth for adapting our functional wax on it. Now, after adapting the functional wax, you can place the patient's mouth and ask the patient to power bite in centric and then followed by protrusive as well as lateral excursions. As you can see here, the indentations will be marked on the softened functional wax. Now, after these indentations are made, you can place it in ice water and chill it so that it gets set fast. Now place it back to the patient's mouth and fast setting stone is jiggled onto these indentations on the functional wax. And you have to be careful that this should cover the unprepared teeth in the front, that is our key tooth. Okay. So once this is set, you can carefully remove it from the patient's mouth and place it or adapt it onto our upper cast. So here it should properly adapt onto our key tooth. Okay, if there is any discrepancy in the edges, you can slightly trim it off, properly adapt it onto our upper cast, and then you can mount it onto the articulator using this functional core on it or the stone core on it. And once the upper segment is being articulated, you can build the lower base until it contacts the functional core. So this is joined with the lower segment and this is our upper segment. So it's like that. So this is the final picture. So once we articulate our upper segment along with the functional core, we built the lower base and this gap is joined with the POP. So this is how it is made. Now you can do the wax pattern fabrication against this functional core during the wax up stage, or you can wax up against the anatomic model and refine the inclines against the functional core, or you can complete the castings and at the final stage you can trim the metal or porcelain surface during the build up stage after placing it against the functional core. So this can be done in either in any of these steps. So this is the FGP in short. So let me come to an article which will describe again functionally generated path. So this will help you to know in detail how it is done. So this is an article by Duval et al. About application of the functionally generated path technique to restore the mandibular molars in bilateral group function occlusion. It was published in 2013 in the Journal of Prosthodontics, Implant, Aesthetic and Reconstructive Dentistry. So here what they did was that instead of a extra hard base plate wax, they fabricated a stone crib. So this stone crib was adapted onto the lower cast. So this was with particular indentation, so placement was easy, and also it will not allow the material to flow into the oral cavity. So they made a stone crib. For complete adaptation, they applied the tray adhesive and relined it so that it was properly and closely adapted to the oral cavity. So as you can see here, these are the posterior teeth that needs to be restored using not FGP. So these are the indentation so that when we place it back, it properly sits onto position. So this is the putty matrix which act as a base for the placement of our functional wax. So as you can see, 0.5 mm of gap should be there between the matrix and the opposing teeth for our placement of functional wax. Now they have placed first the stone crib into the patient's mouth, followed by the putty matrix. Upon this, they have placed the softened functional wax and asked the patient to power bite in centric and then do the protrusive as well as lateral excursions, which will be recorded in this functional wax. Now, after this, they are applying the fast setting stone completely over the stone crib as well as the functional record. Once this is set, it is carefully removed along with the stone crib. So this is mounted onto the articulator. So as you can see, this is a stone crib along with the FGP record. This is the particular area that needs to be restored, and then it is mounted. So this is our area that needs to be restored, and this is the functional core. There are other names for functional core are stone core, stone counter, functional index or counter die. And here they have done the wax up against this functional core. So this is the wax up stage, and they have fabricated gold crowns for this lower posteriors. So this is the final stage where the lower posteriors are restored with gold crowns. So this is a functionally generated path technique. Now here is a case report by Dr. Kiran et al. On full mouth rehabilitation of bone dentition using Pankhiman-Schuller technique and Broderick's flag method. So here the patient complained of difficulty in chewing on both sides and also sour taste. So in initial diagnosis, it was found that there was around 4 mm loss of vertical dimension. So diagnostic impressions were taken of the upper as well as the lower, and face bone was taken and the upper teeth was mounted, and the centric record was taken using Lucia jig, and the lower cast was mounted using this centric record. And once articulation was done, the occlusal plane analysis was done using the Broderick's occlusal plane analyzer, and proper occlusal plane was established. Meanwhile, the patient was given an occlusal splint at an increased VD to check for her function as well as comfort. And then the first segment, that is the lower anteriors, were prepared, followed by temporary cementation. Then the upper anteriors were prepared, again followed by temporary cementation, and anterior guidance was harmonized, and the mandibular posteriors were prepared, followed by maxillary posteriors. So after the mandibular posteriors were set, the maxillary posteriors were fixed using the functionally generated path technique. So this is the post-op front view. So this is a summary of our Pankhiman-Schuller philosophy or Pankhiman-Schuller technique. So first impressions were taken, face bow transfer, mounting of the maxillary cast using the face bow, then centric record by Lucia jig, mounting of the mandibular cast by centric record. Then next step, occlusal plane analysis and the mox wax up at increased VD. Occlusal splint at increased VD was given. Then the mandibular anterior preparation followed by temporization and cementation. Then the maxillary anterior preparation followed by temporization and cementation. Mandibular posterior preparation followed by temporization. Maxillary posterior preparation by functionally generated path technique followed by temporization. The temporaries were given for a period of 3 weeks, and then the final cementation of mandibular posteriors and maxillary posteriors. So thank you all for watching my video. Here comes the end of our session of Pankhi-Manchula philosophy. Please do like, share it among your friends and subscribe my channel if you are finding these videos useful. If you have any doubts or any suggestions, please do message in the comment section below, or you can directly mail me at this mail ID. So we'll be discussing our next session, Hobo technique, twin stage and twin table technique. And until then, bye from ProstoHub. Thank you all.